My father would lift me high.
Thank you, Mr. Kingsley.
And dance with my mother and me, and then spin me around till I fell asleep. Would carry me, and I knew for sure I was loved. If I could get another chance, another dance with him, I'd pray it's all that would never end. How I'd love my mother with my father again. When I hear my mother kissing, my way I would run from her to him. He made me laugh just to comfort me. Yeah, yeah, then finally make me do just what my mama said. Later that night when I was asleep, yeah, under my sheet, never dreamed that he would be gone from me. I could spill one final breath, one final step, one final dance with him. I'd play a song that would never end, cause I'd love my mother to dance with my father again. Sometimes I'd listen outside, and I'd my I know I'm praying too much, but the only man she loved. I know you don't do it usually, but Lord, she's dying to dance with my father again. Every night I fall asleep, and this is all I ever
like from out of a dream. And in this dream, there was a major diva in the wings. She will appear out of somewhere. There's always beauty in my life. The only thing that's right. My first love.
That I say, you step on me.
I want to share all my love with you. No one else will do. You know it. Your eyes, they tell me how much you care. Oh yes, you will always be my endless love.
Mariah Carey.
this young man just texted me right now. He took action with my program, which most people don't.
Before the second show,
hello, Kingsley. Hello, Kingsley.
Mr. Kingsley. Hello, Mr. Kingsley.
Feliz,
Gabriel, good afternoon, sir.
How about you now?
I'm fine, thank you, sir.
When are we starting the training?
Fine, sir. We're just trying to entertain. Let's say in the next 5 minutes. Okay. That's why we're just playing music, sir.
I said, let me ask the moderator.
Okay, sir.
So I'm on board.
Yes, sir.
Thank you very much. Appreciate it.
Hello, we are already 10, sir.
Kingsley, how are you?
All right, thank you so very much. Good afternoon, everybody.
Good afternoon, sir.
Good afternoon.
Mr. Felix, please, you can turn off the music now. We are grateful. I want to once again welcome each and every one of us to today's section. Again, I want to appreciate us for going through with this section yesterday. I was on an unfortunately absent. Very quickly, we'll be taking the presentation on fiber optics, and Mr. Usman Abdulkadir will be taking us through that. So he's already prepared. So I'll call on him without wasting time to go through fiber optics. If we have questions, we can ask at the end of the presentation. Thank you so much. Mr. Usman, you have the floor.
Good afternoon, everyone. I still remain on the existing protocol.
Good afternoon.
I'm honored to be taking this part of the networking. I think all the facilitators.
Sorry, Usman. Mr. Kingsley, please, can you just...
I just saw it now. I didn't see that Mr. Gabriel was even online.
Okay, please.
Mr. Usman, just hold on a bit. Let's just do a brief introduction, please.
Okay.
For those of us that may not have met him, but I'm sure everybody will have met him, the Iroko of ICT Department. The IPS manager. He is the other person than Mr. Oladapo Gabriel. Please let us welcome Mr. Gabriel on board, please.
You're welcome, sir.
Thank you very much.
You're welcome, sir.
Thank you very much, everybody, my colleague. I'm glad to be on board. I wish us a fruitful deliberation. Happy listening. Thank you very much.
Thank you so much, sir. We are so happy to have you on board. At least we now have a representative of the GM ICT now. All this while I have been acting in his stead. So, Mr. Gabriel, you have to take over and do a formal opening remark for us before we continue.
Okay. Once again, I want to appreciate the initiator of this wonderful gesture. Is indeed a new dawn in the department. And we really appreciate that. And I want to appreciate all my colleagues who have connected, who have deemed it fit, even in this tight period of ours, to take up this opportunity to not to be locked down, but to still, while at staying home and staying safe, still be learning and getting some new ideas. And today, being the topic of optical fiber, I want to encourage you to please pay rapt attention to understand it's a very wonderful area. And I want to believe that no knowledge will be lost. Whatever you can get, we have been upgrading some of our terrestrial connection in our post offices to optical fiber. We have just newly deployed one to the IMPC at NACO office. So you may need to understand one or two things because you never can tell. You may have to come to the office to deploy any of those optic fiber. So once again, I want to appreciate every one of us. Happy listening. And once again, thank you, Mr. Kingsley, and the rest of the crew. God bless you all.
Thank you so much, sir. All right. Like I said, without wasting time, there wouldn't be need for us to do any other formal introduction. If you need to know the people online, just go to the participant list, and I'm sure you will see the people online. Well, at the end of this presentation, there will be room for us to ask questions, like the acting GMICT said. Let us be attentive to this presentation. It is kind of, to some of us, it may be very strange because it's different from the regular operation presentation, IPMS, IPS, and the others. So I think it's something we should pay keen interest to. All right, Mr. Usman, you have the floor.
Thank you, Mr. Kingsley. And once again, thank you, Mr. Gabriel. I really appreciate your presence in this platform, and I also want to explain all these things I've done within my best time. With the best material I've had. Now today we'll be going through distinct fiber optics, and I said earlier, most of the time I've conducted this training, it's for all professionals in the field. But I've tried my possibility to slim fit it to a beginner's level, in which it was defined by the moderator that I had to bring it to the grassroots level, but I shouldn't bore the whole class with the nitty-gritty of the whole fiber optics installation. The only thing I should just go straight to the point and see the part in which we as ICT officers need to understand. So I was able to come up with a slide and also divide the class into two. I think the first one is understanding fiber optics, then the second and the third, and the second class is going to be connectors and identifications, and which it's going to be, because of the time constraint, I would prefer we do it in two batches. I hope if that's okay with the moderator. Now, the first thing we need to do is to go through the objectives. The objective is to know this thing, the optical network. When we hear of
fiber optic, volume, sir. Please, volume, sir.
Hello, can you hear me?
This is low. Just increase your voice, please.
Okay. We need to talk about the optical network and its advantages, the fiber design and types, principle of operation, light source amplifiers, dispersion and attenuations, attenuators, mole feed diameter, and also we have wavelength with WDMs and DWDMs. When we come to that, we'll know all the what all this are all about. First of all, we just have to know, okay, what is an optical network? An optical network doesn't need any long English language or definition. It's just like passing through a glass material, in which everybody, when you hear fiber optic, we think there's anything special. There's nothing special about it. It's just a backbone in which you transmit signal. And the signal transmitted is in form of light signal, and in which is being decoded into zeros and ones. And also we've tried to like streamline this thing down to like, okay, how do people translate this? How is this signal translated? They've come with different types of technology to undo this. But the simple definition of this thing, of optical network is light moving through a glass medium from one point to another. That is, when you send signal from the distant transmission end to the receiving end using fiber glass strands. And these fiber glass strands are what we call fiber optics. Then its advantages, I'll just dive into that immediately because we want to talk about this thing. Yeah, its advantage, this thing relative to copper, conventional network. It's like, it's vast. Why am I saying it's vast? Because it has this exceptional bandwidth. It can pull. We say the speed of light from this thing, from the sun down to earth, is about 3 × 10⁸ meter per second. Signal move in glass strand at the speed of 2 × 10⁸. That's how fast these signals move. So day in, day out, we always want to improve just because of the demand for exchange of internet sharing, broadband penetration along the country. We want to improve on our signals. There's this conspiracy that came out sometimes back in which they were saying 5G network is being deployed. I was so shocked when I saw people deploying fiber. Ordinary fiber, when you deploy fiber, it doesn't mean that you're deploying a network. You are just deploying a backbone in which this network will work. So these are the things we need to we need to get ourselves used to and also know about, not that someone will just come in, tell you a lot of things and which is not the same. So it has this exceptional bandwidth, its ability to carry different signal concurrently. I think all of us here might have heard of what we call this thing, voice over IP. We've heard this thing. We shouldn't even say voice over IP. Let's just say, okay, our primitive on phones, we do WhatsApp call now before we don't have application that make us only dial number and make up through the cell towers. Now we have application that, okay, everything is moving from communication technology to IT technology. That is, develop software that make people to communicate with one another. So using fiber optic as a medium allow you to move 1, 2, 3 signals. And when we say the three signals, we have voice, we have internet, and we have video. All these things can work concurrently on one single strand of a fiber optic cable. So it is immune to electromagnetic interference. Unlike copper, that you can't run copper together side by side with electric cable. Fiber optics, run anything on it, it doesn't have electromagnetic interference. There's nothing like corona effect or electromagnetic interference on this. Then also it does not emit any electromagnetic distortion. It's just a glass strand that allows light to pass through it. Same also, it does not corrode like copper. It has resistance to eavesdropping. If if most of you have gone to telephony, I can go and eavesdrop. Eavesdrop in the sense that I can go and tap into someone's network from the hub or from a substation to listen to the communication they have. But with fiber optics, nobody can tap into. It's a glass. How will you separate? Even what technology will you have to tap into a signal that is moving concurrently? Like you're using one light and this is fiber strand that is moving different signal with multi-producing. Before you even identify the signal that is coming from what particular place, you've already existing. It will never be successful reaching that. Then it virtually is a future-proof technology. Future-proof technology in the sense that you can deploy this for 10 years and it still remain, you can still integrate it to any upcoming network. 10, 20 years, fiber optics, you can only replace the cable, but this technology will still stay and serve the existing, incoming network. Unlike if you've learned with the communication technology, we've moved from from 2G edge network to 3G. In some countries, every of these networks were integrated on fiber optics, from their edge network to from GPRS to edge, from edge to 2G, to 3G, from 3G to 3.5G, from 3.5G to 3.75G, from 3.75 to 4G, from 4G light to 4.5. All these were being integrated on fiber optics. Unlike Nigeria, that we're using microwave radios, countries like US, where the fiber optics have been run since 1993, countries like Estonia have a fully deployed system to the whole country where you have FTTX, that's fiber to anywhere, in places like Estonia, they don't even use paper documentation to do any of their services. They have a holistic network that, okay, they dive into to do the activity. So it's future-proof. You can deploy any network based on this thing, irrespective of the upgrade you have. Now, if at all we have a fiber optic network controlling our 3.5G, 3.75, and 4G in Nigeria, anytime 5G comes, it can still work on this. It works on this fiber optic backbone. So it has the capability to operate in conjunction with concurrent and proposed LAN. That is when I talk about integration, I'm talking about, okay, you have a LAN network, you have a WAN network. WAN network, you can integrate your LAN on fiber. Just let's take an example, like a corporate headquarters. We can run fiber to each DEX, but we can run LAN to each DEX. But between each our building and the galaxy we are using fiber to communicate. That is, this signal comes in with full force and then it gets distributed using what we call media converters, network switches. So when it comes, we have we talk about that when we talk about tomorrow or next time we meet on the kind of media devices we use to bring in this network, to accept in this network. And from when we deploy a full network, then it's lightweight and easy to undo. And also the pulling strength is higher than copper. When you see a full fiber optic cable, people confuse it with armored cable, in the sense that this cable, it's so packed together and the strength member in the cable protect the cable around, because you have different level of sheets before you even can access this cable. It's a fiberglass strand. I think some of us might have seen it. It's not as thick as our hair. Our hair is thicker than this strand, the core of a fiber. That's one crazy thing about the whole thing. You're like, what this simple tiny thing, what can you do? It can move a lot of things within just a single second. Now, we are the fiber. Let me talk about the design. The design is just we have the buffer, we have the core, and we have the cladding. The buffer is just a protective coat around the core and around the cladding, and the cladding is the one that shields the core. So my training, most of the time when you're doing professional training, they will bring questions like this, in which they should identify most of the distinct part of the fiber design, in which the core, the main, it's at the center of the cladding, and the coating, the strength member, and the jacket. Strength member, we have different strength member irrespective of where it is being deployed. We have fiber for plenum, that's a tight piece. We have this thing, fiber for this thing, OFR, that's fiber optic riser for tall vertical buildings. It also have different member. We have this thing, submarine cable, which also have different strength member. We have the one that will run on power lines. I think this thing, I was discussing with someone earlier the other day that, okay, we have fiber on this thing, our national grid. And the person was like, how? How manage? But when you check our national grid, you even see the domes, determination boxes on the national grid, in which most of the, I think, FIS3 telecoms and also Galaxy down the south, using this network to communicate with different places. So now, this is a pure comparison between fiber optics. Are we there? Hello?
Yes.
Okay. Yes, we are listening.
Please, if I'm fast, call me back because I'm trying to finish the whole slide within this structure. So we have a single copper pair. A single copper pair is capable to carry only 6 phone calls. Why if this thing, where while a single fiber is capable to carry 2.5 million simultaneous call concurrently, and you can see the from the distance, you can see the copper cable and also the fiber cable. So you should know that this thing is just like a latest technology in which we need to. And seriously, in Nigeria, I'm still ashamed to say that we don't have a fiber producing company in Nigeria till now. I don't know what's happening, but as sort of 10 years back, South Africa, we were able to to produce a fiber, this thing, fiber optic cable, in which it is being used worldwide now. Well, this technology, we need to just grab it immediately. And if you notice these days, you can see that even the telcos are deploying this to their cell sites. They're deploying so that they can have faster network. The demand for a fast network is always crazy when it comes to the, keeping your customers. Because when your network is low, people don't patronize your business. These guys are fully deploying this thing. And I can vouch that, okay, as sort of last 2 years, Airtel signed a distant agreement to deploy, do national broadband penetration for this thing for over $6 billion across the whole nation. And up till now, they're still deploying this network since last 2 years. So also MTN, so also Glo. They want to reach this capacity. They want to reach every corner of Nigeria to be a service provider the whole nation can be proud of. Now, information carrying capacity. If from this, you can see that a pair of copper voice frequency 2,400 copper voice frequency is just like the same thing. But when you take, two single mode fiber cable and what it can transmit, you see that the speed is even crazier than what the primitive network we have. Now, this shows how crazy these speeds are. When you look at infrared laser, which we were using before, 155 Mbps for only 6 kilometer, and you look at the radio, the upgrade, radio IEEE, 802.1b and 2.1, you can see the speed and distance limitation. Bluetooth 10 meter, copper Cat5e 100 meter, Cat6 100 meter. When you come to multi-mode fiber optic, when you see 62.5/1, the 62.5 is the core size. Core size, and the 125 is the cladding distance. Both propagate a speed of 10 gigabytes per second at 33 meter, at 82 meter, at 300 meter. When you look at multimode fiber, you know that, okay, this is what we use within a building. Within a building, a multimode fiber, it can go for this length. When you look at single mode fiber on this side, this thing, you know that, see that this propagates more than 10 gigabytes per second and more over 5 to 40 kilometers before you can repeat that signal. And when you look at it, the distance, the frequency, it's greater than 1 terahertz. This shows that fiber optic is the order of the day. We need to just deploy this network. And it works. How it works is simple. We have we just go back to our our primitive physics class, in which we have Snell's law. Does anyone remember Snell's law? Hello, class.
Yeah.
So when you look at this thing, light moves into the core from a place of lower refractive index to a place of lower refractive index to a higher refractive index. That's just a simple law. And this light is being guided by what we call the cladding. Enters the core, go to the cladding, bounce back, go continuously. And this is what we call the zeros and one in digital technology. And with this, information is being sent and received from the transmitter end to the receiver end. And in which, this is just a practical example. We have what we call total internal reflection, when this light moves from one place to another, in which you achieve the critical angle. And if you see from the diagram, you can see some demonstration in which the light bounce and move again. So now, in the fiber technology, we have a lot of types of way is in which light move into the core. And when total internal reflection occur, what and what will happen? In the first technology, we have a step index in which that the lights just go in. It's not guided. It bounces off the cladding, comes down, go again. It's just in an haphazard way. Sometimes the signal is being lost. So we came about what we call a graded index. And what a graded index guides the light to form a perfect wave pulse and wavelength within the core, in which it's faster at the same time, no signal is being lost. So step index is always used in a typical example of plastic fiber, in which is on the screen now. So now, how is the optical fiber made? This is simple. I just say, let's just see, or I'm going to send the link of the video later, but I just say, let me just talk about it a little bit. We have what they call soot. This soot, it's like a glass tube. It's been heated. Soot perfume is being heated. It's being heated for over 2,000 degrees. Then the fiber is being drawn out of it. It's being drawn out of it in a matter of some seconds, and it's being rolled to a spool. And this is just a pure step in which it doesn't require anything, much technology, but just some standards to make the to draw the fiber into a drum. But when I share the link, you see how the whole thing is being done. And the crazy thing is that it's from glad that it's being heated, and the tiny fibers have been drawn out. So we have some parameters we need to look into, in which a lot of people wouldn't know about. We have a wavelength. When you're talking about bandwidth, you talk about wavelength. We're talking about We're talking about mode of propagation. You talk about wavelength, in which signals are being transmitted. So we are, and this, and at every point in time, we have different speed, different wavelengths, and which network network speed is being transmitted. And what I would say about this is that we have your from attenuation occur at this time at different wavelengths, and attenuation is always higher when you have wider distance. Let me say, attenuation is higher when the speed, the wavelength, it's the wavelength is wider. Do you understand what I'm saying? When I mean attenuation, signal loss happens when the crest, the distance between one crest and another, the other, it's very wide. So you can see that when this thing, we always want to like bring a lot of things when it comes to the speed and which wavelength in which signal travels. So this is a typical example of a step index. Then we'll call intermodal dispersion. Intermodal dispersion, when you look at this picture I've just shown you, you see signal coming into the core, and the signal being received is being distorted. That is, there is modal dispersion within the core, so which brought about a graded index, so that the signal that is being transmitted is not lost. So look at the difference between the graded index and the step index. And you can see that the step index, with the graded index, you have a lot of the same signal being received at the end of the signal propagation. So now we have multimode step index, which is a plastic fiber. We have multimode graded index, which is a glass fiber. And also we have single mode. Single mode doesn't have any graded index, it's just one. And multimode fiber optic cables are used within the plant. Then within the plant or within a building, while single mode are used for long haul from city to city, from point of presence to from point of presence to a building. You can't use a multimode because of the distance it can reach. So now we have different core and cladding size. If you remember earlier, I was saying that the cladding is the 125 meter. Distance, 125 micro, where the distance the core is 50. When you look at this, we have a core and cladding. For multimode, we have 50 by 125, 62.5 by 125. And for the plastic fiber also, we have 140 by 100. While in the single mode, which is 9 microns, it is 9 microns by 125. The size of our air is 10 to 12 micron diameter, while the size of the core for a single fiber, you should know how tiny it is 9 micron. Then numerical aperture. Numerical aperture doesn't really state a lot. It's just an imaginary acceptance cone that is being formed for a light to properly enter the core. I don't need to stress this. It's just like, okay, how do lights enter the core or the fiber optic core? This technology has already been defined by the connector in which that is going to send the signal. But the numerical aperture is the cone being formed before this light goes into the core immediately. So we have transmitters and light source. Transmitter and light source, LED cannot modulate faster than this speed. But we have vertical cavity surface emitting lasers, which are low-cost lasers that operate within 5,815 nanometers. That's the wavelength on multi-mode fiber and support gigabits. But for single-mode transmitter, are typically on what we call feedback edition. Is either on a distributed feedback or fiber perot lasers. These are based on the speed in which the light is being propagated. So difference between single mode and multi-mode. Single mode eliminates modal dispersion, enables very long distance transmission. The numerical aperture requires more alignment before light can travel, then requires more expensive transmitter. and connectors installation. And then, now, if this signal is being propagated, like, okay, let's say submarine cable that comes from the UK comes to our shores in Lagos, you don't expect us to run only once a single cable without signal loss. We have repeaters, we have amplifiers, we have amplifiers that can do this job. Immediately we get to a certain distance, these signals are being repeated to boost the signal over this the range into in which it's traveling. So we have this electronic repeater. It's very okay, but it's very primitive and also requires what we call power source. And if I'm running a cable from UK to Nigeria, there's no way I'm going to deploy power for a submarine cable, because this under the deep sea, power can never be deployed to such place. So this electronic repeater can only work within the metro, and also it's not advisable because you still have to go look at the cost of deploying power source to that particular location. So it's always used in buildings within the town, so not within a long all distance. But what they have, what we call ABM dope amplifier. ABM dope amplifier is like a doped fiber with ABM, and that ABM is like a catalyst. When you connect it, it's just like you connect it to a pump. A pump means a signal pump, and this boosts the signal. This boosts the signal over long distance. We also have Raman application. Also, it's still the same mean distance, but it's from a pump distance. From a pump to a pump, but ABM dump is from a pump to the long all fiber. So, optical attenuator. Attenuation, what I said earlier on, where I said attenuation is loss of signal, but we have optical attenuator, in the sense that anything that has a disadvantage has its own advantage. When you when you apply all this ABM dope application to this thing, or RAMA application, this thing gives a power, a great source of this thing boost to a signal. And when this thing hits an active device, sometimes damages the active device. So what we really do, we do some of the time, is that when you deploy this kind of amplification, you also have to put this thing at the end, and this thing, an attenuator to regulate the signal that we hit the active device. So it reduces the power of signal traveling over this thing, and also without distorting the waveform. So dispersion. Now, I said something that, okay, dispersion is not attenuation. Attenuation is loss of signal, but dispersion is distortion in signal. Loss of signal is different from distortion of signal. Thus, we have two types of dispersion. We have modal dispersion, found only in multimodal, and we have chromatic dispersion. So, chromatic dispersion. So, chromatic dispersion, only happens when you have light traveling at different wavelengths. And most of the time, it happens in a step index fiber optics, which is most of the plastic fiber. So also, we'll talk like, okay, frequency is also an essential parameter in this, and in which frequency has to do with also the higher the frequency, the shorter the wavelength, and the shorter the wavelength, the higher the frequency. So mode fit diameter. Mode fit diameter also translate to mode fit is translated to the translate to the distribution of light through the core and the cladding. This is just a standardization you need to meet when a company is designing fiber optic, but we don't need to be bother ourselves with this. It's just something we need to have at the back of our mind, that when someone is deploying fiber to your place, you need to say, okay, what's the measure and the mode fit diameter measurement? And it's always found in the product spec, so that you won't be taking bringing something that is meant for a riser or a conductor. Optical fiber conductor and non-conductor. And if you're bringing a conductor to a place whereby there is is non-conductive. You should see this in a spec, the product spec there, and you should be able to refuse this or reject what the installer is bringing. So this is a technology in which they use to separate different wavelengths. If signal is being propagated, we'll call it wavelength division multiplexer. Multiplexing in general is when you mash different wavelengths together. Then we have what we call demultiplexing. But in a place whereby you have different signals traveling concurrently, and you want to deploy this thing, that's when you have a dense wavelength division multiplexer. Multiplexing, and also the same technology you use for your wavelength division multiplexer, that's what you use for your dense wavelength, but it will be a step higher in the sense that you have to demultiplex, then you come and do your wavelength division multiplexer. And this thing easier being experienced when you have a prism. You know, when you separate different lights using a prism during your physics practical in the old days, different light traveling through a prism. When a ray hits the prism, you can see different light, then you can be able to identify and separate each light. This is just a practical example how wavelength division multiplexer works. It is easy to understand. Consider the fact that you can see many different colors of light, light, red, green, yellow, blue, etc., and so on. And the colors have been transmitted through air together and may mix, but they can easily be separated using a device like prism. Thank you very much. So, well, then, this is a solution. We need to, like, okay, get to this thing. I could tell you. We have FTTH, we have HTTP, we have HTTC, we have FTTN, we have FTTX. But all in all, it's just FTTX, fiber to anywhere. And when you say fiber to anywhere, it means that, okay, you can take fiber to even your parlor, fiber optic to your sitting room. You can deploy fiber optic to anywhere at this present technology we have now, in the sense that the amount of data you need at a particular point determines the speed, or the amount of exchange of data you need at a particular place determines what you are deploying there. So in some estates in Abuja now, presently, I know, yes, they've deployed fiber to such places. And unlike the primitive, okay, I want to use what we call, okay, I want to deploy telephone lines within this state. When you have fiber deployed to each house, trust me, every call being made within the estate has no charge. There's no charge to it, because this fiber you deploy allow what they call a network in which you can communicate. The only thing, you just need to have your active devices within those buildings, and that's it. You have your telephone lines working. That's one. Number two, it's also aid what we call IoT, Internet of Things. Number three, we also have what we call smart homes. All these are what enhance what we call fiber optics are what enhance all these processes. We don't then if you look at this thing, unlike our primitive DSL, in which we call digital subscriber line on our patient telephones, that okay, you want to use this with fiber optics, we have three major players. The voice, the internet, and the video. All these things, broadband over power lines, they are obsolete. What they call total obsolete, in the sense that you don't need to worry yourself about, okay, how will I manage to get my internet out of? No, with fiber optics, what you just need an ISP to come and terminate. Okay, send signal, not even to come and terminate, send signal when you have a fully fiber optic network deploy to your area. And now I want to show this a typical fiber optic deploy service within a state or a particular area. At their central office, we have what they call OLT, we have what the WDMs, we have your amplifiers, you have FDF, fiber distribution frame. From there, a feeder is being taken to your outside plant. And your outside plant, what do you have? A fiber distribution hub in which every distribution hub, there's nothing special there. You just have a switch and your patch panel there, in which, okay, this link is coming from this. So we need to distribute this network across this thing. What we call a layer three switches. And if you are conversant with layer three switches, we have layer three fiber switches. It takes in signal and distributes over other switches, and in which we call it an aggregate switch. And this aggregate switch is just like, okay, we aggregate everything, then send it out, and that's it. From that terminal, you see, it drops to ONT, and ONT, optical network terminal, from optical terminal, that's to the house. And that's how a full fiber optic, this picture now, I don't want to go to the details because I don't want to confuse us more. This is a typical picture stating that, okay, this is how fiber optic is being deployed. Hello, are we there?
Yes.
Hello.
Hello, we are with you.
Okay.
Yes, thank you. Are here. We are with you.
My screen just went off. So I'm trying
to bring it back. Okay.
Now we have already seen free space optics. This is just a line of
we can't see your screen. No, we can't see your screen.
You can't see my screen. Wow.
Yes.
Okay, I'm coming.
Maybe you have pressed something.
Can you see my screen now?
Yes, we can see it.
Yes.
Okay, let me share it to you again. Now, with this, FSO means free space optics. Free space is just a beam of light communicating with one building and the other. This is a very cheap way of running fiber. You don't need to dig any ground. But from one building, from line of sight of a building to the other building, you can see that, okay, there's communication. But the great major advantage of this is that if anything passed through that signal, there's going to be network interruption, and which is going to be very, very bad. But it's just like this thing, building communicating with one another. But it's the cheapest and the simplest method of deploying optics to a metropole. So that's the end of today's class. I don't want to go more detail on the understanding of fiber, but I would prefer we schedule another class for connectors and identification, in which that one is gross and vast. But at the end of this class, if questions doesn't come, I still have a revision question prepared for the class, so we can still go through that.
Thank you.
Hello.
Mm-hmm. Thank you.
Okay.
Mr. Kingsley, are you there?
Yes, I am. Yes, I am. Mr. Usman, thank you very much. I will not be surprised if there's no question. But all the same, let me just see. Samsudin already has one for you, or maybe more than one. Mr. Samsudin, you have the floor, please.
Yes, sir. I just want to clarify my understanding on the lectures. What I understand is that we have two different mediums of fiber optic. I'm just using my language. It may be wrong. We have plastic and the glass. Then we have different. Let me say, all these were used in different, like the single mode and the multi-mode.
Multi-mode. Mm-hmm.
Multi-mode. And those multi-mode were the one used at homes or at offices. Am I right?
Yes.
So now my question is that, are they going to replace the Cat 6 and Cat 5 cable that we used to know? And if it is true, can they work directly with our conventional switch, or they have their own special switches? That's one. The second question is that we know about analog, the form of propagating signals. We have We know most of these network mediums, most of them carries the analog signals. Is analog signals that were being converted at the to digital signal by our devices. So in fiber optic, we are talking about light. And this light carries different signals, video, audio, internet, and what have you. So I just want to know, in what form does this fiber optics propagate or carry these signals? Is my question clear, sir?
Okay, it's very clear. Thank you for the first question.
And I just want to, and again, I want you to relate, because I have knowledge about electromagnetic, or let me say electromagnetic wave. So can you relate this technology with electromagnetic wave as we know it?
Okay, number one, let me answer the question one after the other. Number one, you asked of this thing. We have a single mode, multi mode, and also this thing. Yes, single mode. Every of this type of fiber have its own uses. Multi mode is within the premises. If you look at the picture I showed you earlier, multi mode doesn't work for long ranges because of this thing. The in which the waveform in which the light enters through the core. It work within building. But even till today, I will assure you that now, most of the fiber deploy site, you won't even see the single mode within offices. Why? They've even gone upgraded this, you won't see the multi-mode within the offices. They've upgraded by even running a pigtail that has, or a fiber patch cord that is a single mode. That is single mode and run it within the office, but it's not taking over the existing LAN that you said in this thing. I also want to like stress on the this thing. Most of our electronic devices, we have TV, laptops, these. The ability of them to process fast is because they've deployed a plastic fiber within them for it to transmit signals from the within its processes. Because back then when we were making research, we found out that plastic fiber was deployed into most of these Alienwares. Have you heard of, if at all you've heard of Alienwares, there's a type of laptop that processes a lot of activity. It's a gaming laptop.
Yeah.
When you open the back, you see plastic fiber within, trying to make the communication, the processes within the system faster. So all this had been done to just like, fiber optics is not a network, but a backbone in which a network travel. Do you understand now? A backbone in which the network travel, which comes to your second question, stating that, okay, is it going to take over the existing LAN? No, it won't.
Okay.
But at this junction in which we are now, is that we are being left behind. Why in Nigeria, what we deploy this an integrated network in the sense that fiber is being run to a building, then we integrate it online. That is, there is a switch that has fiber optic, this thing, what we call SFP.
Mm-hmm.
SFP is single, this thing, simple form pluggable. It's what the fiber terminates and it is being connected to the switch.
Okay.
So signal with light is being transmitted and is converted to a digital signal at that point. Then from that switch again, it's, you connect your LAN cable and pick your signal direct.
Okay.
With that, it's still faster. So it's not taking over any technology. We integrate it on LAN and WAN, as I've said earlier. It's not taking over any technology. But also now, because of human nature of, okay, I want a faster data. In developed world, we don't even inculcate all this, integrate this with LAN again. Fiber is being run directly to the house and being terminated on the active devices in the house. So if you check most of your TV, latest TV, it has fiber terminated port or LAN terminated port. That is when your fiber is being deployed to the house, there's a device in which you terminate it. Thereby, you don't need to have your Wi-Fi. within the house. Your internet is being deployed to the house. You via that distance, via that device. You don't need to be a certain network.
At this juncture, you got me confused again. I think my question is going to where you are talking about now, because in the course of your presentation, you says that fiber is now being deployed direct to the active devices. So isn't that what the work of our land and our what have you?
That's what I'm saying now. I said, just because of human nature, okay, I want to have faster data.
Faster, okay, I understand. Uh-huh.
So fiber is being deployed to the home directly.
Okay.
I want a faster network. I don't want, because there's a particular amount of speed LAN all this Cat5, Cat6 cable can carry concurrently. Yeah. But for fiber, it is vast. So have you seen a fiber optic cable before within your building?
I only saw it on picture, sir.
Picture. So have you ever identified, okay, this is a fiber being terminated to a switch?
Yeah, we were, when I was undergraduate, we were being taken to one lab like that. I have seen it.
What color is the cable?
I think the cable is somehow bluish, average.
Blue. When you see blue, green, brown, ash, blue. Those are multi-mode.
It's blue and green, I saw. Yeah.
They are multi-mode cable. Then when you see yellow, I think everybody in headquarters might have seen what the yellow cable, and the yellow cable is what they call single mode.
Single mode.
So that's the difference between when you go to a site, you see a multi-mode and single mode. Single mode always come in yellow color. Answered your question. Okay, you talk about electromagnetic. Electromagnetism happen in metallic objects. You don't get it in glass. Glass doesn't emit any electromagnetism. Electromagnetism happens not to happen in this thing within the core because of the protective shield it has.
Okay.
Do you understand?
Yes, sir. Mm-hmm. What propagates the light for, as in the source? Does the light being sourced into the fiber optic?
Okay. Now, it's just, okay. I said something about the Perut lasers and also Vatica.
I remember.
Mr. Usman, please, there are other people who have questions, so let's make it a bit faster.
Okay, let me just make it faster. Yeah. Okay. These signals come in zeros and ones.
I said this question, this person has dragged this question for too long, please.
Okay, sorry.
People ask questions.
This thing comes in zeros and one. It is being encoded and sent into light pulse. If you check, everything I'm showing to you is within a light pulse. But this light pulse move at what we call wavelength and frequencies. That's what makes it zeros and one. So when it is being transmitted, it's being decoded back to your zeros and one, which is a digital network. It's this. It's within just a small device, not something spectacular at the tip of the fiber. So that's all.
All right. Thank you so much. Mm-hmm. Thank you for the clarification, Samsudin. I hope most of them are clear, if not all.
Yes, sir.
I had to say it like that because I know you probably not be satisfied. Well, my yoga is. He wants to say something, Mr. Gabriel. Please, you have the floor.
Yeah, thank you very much, Bondreton. Mr. Osman, I must say, let me start by commending your efforts. That's a brilliant presentation. It has been very educative and informative. However, I have one comment and one question.
Okay.
Let me start by the way of comment. You know, all of us are still aspiring to become an international trainer.
Okay, sir.
And I don't know, maybe the coordinator have actually done that, but I feel majority of us, we don't know you. So it would have been very good if before your presentation, you let us know a little about yourself as to, you know, that you are one of the guys that handle the networks of ICT department and stuff like that, you know, so that can give us that some respite. Secondly, While Shamsuddin was talking about optic fiber, I actually want to see something like the background, because when Mr. Kingsley was saying whether he was scared, whether that would be the question, I'm sure he was trying to preempt us, whether we actually understand, because it was becoming technical. And we are not in any of the telcos company. But what I was expecting too, as an observation, is that maybe you take us through a journey that we started with ISDN when we connect through phone.
Wow, yes.
That is one characteristic. We went to the terrestrial where we use all these, VSAT and all those stuff. Most of us there would have known, okay, we have VSAT in our, I think we have seen the VSAT. Then, because of the challenges of maybe, C-band, we get to K-band, KU-band, and all those stuff. Now we are in K-band, and all those ones still have their challenges, which is now leading us to fiber now. And for Samsudin, who said maybe he has not seen much of fiber, you will have said, okay, fine, if you have been journeying from Lagos to Ibadan, all those, you will have seen all those MTN glow, always destroying our road, planting one cable like that. That is what they call fiber, when they always buried on the main highways and all those stuff. And they are doing that across the nation now, and all those stuff. And of course, too, I want to see that the thing is narrowed to our use now in NIPOST. That's okay, mm-hmm. Fine. All the offices that we are using VSAT, NIPOST is making effort to upgrade them to fiber, such as at least Enugu have done it, Keja and the IMPC right now. We have just done ours. And what he said about connecting when it is terminated on an equipment, then we now connect our existing, the indoor equipment you have said. Wonderful. So that's just the gap I felt, so that a lot of us like me who does not know anything about fiber, you will have at least taken care of our, you grow us and to do that. I'm saying now is that, yes, wonderful piece, but the distortion, you only, define the, is it the crow, whatever distortion, you did not mention, maybe you will take time the next topic, next time, the other, there are two type of distortion you mentioned, so you only explained the first one, and I did not hear the second one, so okay, that's just my question, but I hope that I appreciate your training, I benefit okay. so much, okay. Thank you very much, sir.
Thank you very much, sir. Thank you for that swift observation. So I said earlier that I wanted the class to be divided into two categories. I don't want to stretch much on the nitty-gritty or how this thing, because before this class, I think we postponed this class more than five times. Why? Because I was trying to look for a way to start because of this thing. I don't want to go into the history in which the network starts, at the same time, board the whole class. Because when I want to go with that hierarchy, there are a lot of this in process in before the fiber optics come to play. But, also communicated with Mr. Felix and Mr. Kingsley, in which they advised that, okay, I should just go straight and where it's more important for ICT staff in NIPOST. And in which I will still, in our next class, I will still relate to that. Thank you very much. And also for the modal dispersion, the reason why I didn't go into it because we don't need to concern ourselves about the modal dispersion in the sense that it's only happen in rare cases in which it's on and it's graded index. There's impurity in the fiber. That's when modal dispersion happened. That's why I didn't stress on it. But chromatic dispersion, why it's happened at the inception in which light enters through the core. That's why I was like, okay, when light enters through the core with different wavelengths, because I was also stressing on wavelength as the class was going on. But as the next class starts, I'm going to still shed more light and also bring a practical example. That's why I'm like, okay, when in the next class, I would like to explain the connectors and identification, because I was talking about fiber typically today. I didn't say, okay, this is the type of fiber. These the connector, no, because I know if someone needs to have the basic how a fiber optic cable is or what is being used for before we can dive even to connectors, because connector is like a wide range of that we need to know in our office. because when we start with we have different types of connector and different tests in which we run through the connectors when we have issues. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much. I appreciate it. Wonderful.
Thank you so much, sir, for those observations. In fact, it's as if you have poured out my mind, because the last time we had a survey, I was specific that you should break it to our level. To the level that how it affects us as an organization, as a department. So please, when you are coming with the phase two, I think you should focus on that aspect. Okay. Do you understand, Mr. Usman? Yes. You should focus on that aspect so that you will not buzz with the infrastructures, and because I'm not sure we will have cost to go and lay the cable as I see the officer. What would we probably be privy to is where the cable now terminates in our office. So how do we take it from there? And I think that was what Sam Sudin was trying to say.
Yeah,
because like Oga said, Sam Sudin, I'm sure you now know how a fiber cable looks. If you have not, maybe during this lockdown or after the lockdown, you can just take a journey to Lagos by the expressway. You see them digging. Or some may have even passed through the farm, according to Usman the other time. So you know what a fiber cable
is. Sorry, sir. I think one is coming back too. We need to know, for example, they said they have terminated fiber optics in my office now.
How do we go further from there?
And they said 2 meg. I need to know, how do I ascertain that it is 2 meg they have terminated? You understand?
So
you should teach us how in our offices, because Enugu, they have terminated in Enugu, they have terminated in Nikeja. How can we actually identify what is the bandwidth, if it is actually fast and trouble, a little trouble, things like that, so that you can include in your next presentation, sir. Okay, sorry, I'm bothering you.
No, sir.
Sorry,
no, sir.
You can take the presentation.
I can still address that, but since you said okay till the next, because when you say they've terminated 2 meg, 2 meg doesn't relate with fiber optic. 2 meg related with what the ISP is bringing in. The fiber there is just a backbone in which the speed is traveling to. So what our advice is that we still, because we've been fighting this battle for years, that's why I want to talk about it now. I've spoken to everybody in charge.
It's 2 meg not related to. It's 2 meg not related to fiber.
No,
he said no. Now fiber is the backbone. The backbone always network, right? Is that not what you said?
Yes.
Is it not some? Wait.
Is it carrier?
Is it not something that goes through the fiber?
Yes.
No.
Is it not something that goes through the fiber?
Mr. Felix, wait. For example, now. I can have a fiber and Galaxy network will go through it. Am I correct, Usman?
Yes.
Eh?
Yes,
sir.
Uh-huh. So if you want to, Galaxy is giving you 2 meg, will you come and ask me who owns the fiber or the Galaxy that owns the network that goes through it? Do you get what he's trying to say? Do you understand? Yeah.
So
what concerns me is not about the pipe. It's about the network.
That's what I want to talk about. I said,
because at the initial, what prompted us to go and do the pipe? We are complaining about the speed. We want fiber optic. An average user want to see the speed, want to see the magic. You understand? So if you say, what is the Wula value about your fiber optic? Nothing is changing. I cannot, you understand? That's what I'm thinking.
If you can't talk about bandwidth while doing fiber, then there's no need talking about fiber, because the bandwidth actually is the reason for the fiber.
Mr. Felix, if I can clear this to you, when we talk about the distance, the fiber is just a pipe in which the network flows. So the speed does not correlate with the distance. Fiber is just like an open road. This tiny speed pass through. So when you want to test the speed, you always have to go to the network provider stating that they should give you an application in which both of you are in agreement with, so that you can know what is coming in. They will always tell you that you should use speed.net to test the network. It's a lie. Speed.net doesn't give you the actual speed coming through the distance. They should give you an application, and I've always said that NIPO should buy an enterprise application called PRTG. PRTG will give you basic analysis on every network, the speed of the network, the downtime, and also auditing of the network provider. And in with their, they always run away from that when you suggest that to them. That's what I want to say.
Mr. Lecturer, sorry, sir, let me really chip in this one too. I think during the next class, we might help us add to it that fiber can be terminated using some other medium.
Okay.
For example, I'm sure, because some of us may be looking for the cable directly.
No.
It can be terminated maybe through a radio. Are you getting it now? You maybe what just is one of the equipment. Like that of Enugu now. They just brought one cable into the office, one small cable equipment like this. And if there's anybody from Enugu zone here now, they will be wondering, why they say fiber. I'm expecting to see fiber. What is it, this thing that they call fiber? So that maybe you can help us put along those medium or media of terminating in the indoor.
Okay. And also, yes, that's what we call connectors. Connectors. And yes, I will.
Thank you very much.
In summary, thank you so much. In summary, just bring it to our level, to the level we understand, and that the best way it can promote our job. Do you understand? The benefits to us. I think that is it. Thank you so much. Thank you very much. At least we have gotten the bizarre knowledge of optic fiber. Mr. Felix. Mr. Felix.
Mr. Felix. I'm
here. No, I'm here.
Okay. I think the next thing we should do is probably, maybe we should look at that assignment that we were given. What do you think?
Okay.
I think the presentation is finished for today, right?
We have that. We can just bypass that and do the assignment. Just look at the assignment together.
Okay. Okay. Please. Maybe you should project from your project it from your end. I'm using the phone, so I don't want to project from my phone.
Okay.
But I can explain from here.
Okay.
Oh, you can even explain. Have you gone through it?
Yes, I have.
Okay. All right. Good afternoon again, everybody. Or good evening, rather. Sorry. Mr. Gabriel, sir, I hope you are still online.
I'm still with you, sir.
Okay. Sometime last week, during the course of these presentations, Oga attended one of the sections, and he told us that we should come up with a solution that NIPOST can leverage on this season of lockdown to do a pickup and delivery service. The summary of that is that people not turn to online shopping, and most times these people don't even want to leave their home because of the lockdown. So there should be a way where they order things and probably someone come to deliver to them. So we, in order not to overcrowd the committee, we decided to select 6 persons to form a subcommittee to come up with an idea on how best NIPOST can deploy this solution, or the solution that will work best for NIPOST, and how the solution can be rolled out. The subcommittee met last week, and we zeroed in on the already existing NIPOST logistics solution. The reason being that the solution is currently doing a similar thing, or maybe at a different level. So this afternoon, we are going to present the report of that subcommittee to the General House, because the assignment was actually given on this platform. So maybe from the report, we'll take inputs and probably still learn one or two things from what has been done. So that is what we'll be doing this afternoon, sir.
Okay.
Mr. Felix, please.
Yeah, I'm trying to open the PowerPoint presentation. Okay. You know the laptop you people give us now, so it takes a while before the thing actually comes up.
Okay. I've heard of this, so who they supply and who they allocate, they are different too.
while the laptop is booting, Mr. Kingsley, permit me to just breach the protocol and introduce, I have seen two of my guests on the platform, the DZN ICT from Benin Zone. Mr. Thompson Mirabo is on the floor.
He has always been a household member.
Before they will stop my allocation, let me recognize him specially. He's my boss.
Mr. Rabo.
I also want to recognize specially one of my guys I've seen, Madam Modi. all the way from Songwata. I must appreciate
that. Those was their regular caller now. They should be welcoming you now.
In fact, thank you so much for acknowledging them. In fact, Mr. Rabo has been part of this presentation since inception. And I'm not sure, except yesterday, that I was not around.
I'm not your girl.
your girl. Mr. Kingsley. I think, since you have breached the protocol, we should fine him for not attending the classes ever since he started.
Well, I can make an excuse for him. You know, his new assignment is really demanding and tasking. In fact, he has been working around the clock to ensure that the IPS butter is always up and running.
But it's, so not, it's still not it's different. Not... From morning to now, there's no IPS. So even yesterday, the same thing.
Well, no, that's why he was unable to make the meeting.
Nah, he has come home to recharge. He's belonged.
Unfortunately, he was not even online.
He's busy.
When the presentation was made on IPS.
You should understand that he'll be busy now.
Okay, this is what your explanation is sticking. It's accepted.
Well, however, let me not
he's
speak
very
for
busy Oga. Now.
Let Oga speak for himself. Maybe he's been busy in the other room. I don't know.
Mr. Kingsley, this way, you know, who am I to talk when the guys are talking? Mr. I must understand that small boys like us who does not have votes, what do we do? We are just managing. God, they should not be tired of us and continue to encourage us. The IPS, while everybody are enjoying, we are Madam Lamy is on the platform. She knows what efforts we have been put together. The EDI server has just been rectified, and we are working towards putting it on now. But it is well. We will get there. Just continue
Thank
to
you.
Bear with us.
Thank you so much, sir. All right. I think the presentation should be up now, Mr. Felix. Okay, I can just start with a brief introduction.
Please, I'm coming. The laptop is coming up, please.
Should I bring my laptop, Oga Felix?
Get out.
Oga, your laptop is not going to be sitting now. I even start myself. Only the thing got shut down. I called the restart time again.
Let's go, dude.
So please, just okay. 10 minutes. Two minutes.
Okay, for the benefit of those of us that came late, we did announce yesterday that the first 5 persons that will come online this afternoon, we get data recharge. And we are keeping to our promise because we had to screenshot the first 5 persons.
Okay, no wonder.
Okay, I don't understand.
It is okay, well. I understand now.
Okay, what do you understand? So, please, those 5 persons will be getting their data at the close of the section later today.
Can we get their names? Okay, Thompson.
No, he didn't come on time. He even missed out. I think Sam Sudin was online, Mrs. Lamy was online, Patience was online,
Idris
was online, then Usman was online, but because he's a facilitator, we'll have to give his own to someone else.
You have to give his own to me now.
Okay, if we even take the first 10, if we even take the first 10, I don't know if we but...
give me, not Oga. Give me anything yesterday. Give
when
me
you are a, when you are yesterday.
Give me.
Hold on, I'm not doing
yes, yesterday. I was around yesterday. Give me.
All the same. Oga, like Usman, we told him.
You out of your own vote, Abba, give your boys now.
Which vote? Where did I see vote?
I bet,
just leave me. Just leave me, I did on my own.
You see, Mr. Rabot did not request for because he has a vote for data on its own. So why will he be dragging?
Don't give Mr. Rabot. Don't give him
data like this.
Mr. Rabot is a vote controller. Don't give him.
So we have been making mistakes. Give us Mr.
Rabot. He should even sponsor us.
Well,
he should sponsor us.
I beg, return all our refreshment.
Oh, and I did give that will get votes.
Let me project the document so that because I'm having issues. Okay, the laptop has come up. So
please do not. This is serious. Should I bring my own?
It don't come up now. Which one be? Not be what you're not give me. Not be your supplier.
Not be a locator. Not be the supplier.
You know the supplier now. Don't school that. It takes a while. It's coming up.
Okay.
Why we actually the document is coming up. We can also talk about the solution. Yesterday we demonstrated the solution before the entire house. So I believe that majority of people who are actually in the class this afternoon, they are aware. They are fully acquainted with the capability of the solution. So I believe that by the time we bring up the presentation, the reports, they should be able to add their input to the report. It's actually not a new thing. It's an application that has been existing for over a year now. Jumia is actually using it. Afian is using it. Ejurica is also using it. All these are all online merchant shop, e-commerce platform. They actually request for pickup from NIPOST, and when they request for this pickup, they expected that NIPOST gets the notification and go to their offices to go and pick the item. So during this COVID-19, the management is considering actually getting a pickup solution for them. So and we looked at the solution and felt that it's good. Let's make this solution. So let's look at it. It could work for us. So that's why the head of department is mandated that we should create a committee, and we came up with this report, which I'm about to project right now.
If it's not displaying, we can just discuss it and so that we can end the section, have we?
No, please just hold on. It's displaying. It's coming up, please.
Okay.
Sorry about that. Okay, the screen is up. Can you all see my screen?
Yeah, we can see.
Yes.
Hello?
Yes, go ahead.
Hello?
We can see. Yes, we can see your screen.
Mr. Kingsley, are you there?
I am. Can you hear me? Can you hear me, please?
Yes, sir.
Mr. Felix, can you hear me?
I hear you.
Okay, go ahead now. All right, this presentation is actually prepared for the GMICT. Okay. Can you hear me now?
Mr. Yes, Felix. I can hear you.
Go ahead now.
Yes, I can hear you. Can you hear me? Okay, this presentation is actually meant for the it's on intra-city delivery, and it's to be presented to top management tomorrow. They're having a meeting tomorrow by 11. So the top management, they invited Dr. Gaga to do a presentation on the intra-city delivery. So he mandated us that we should come up with something, and we look at the solution and said, instead of actually bringing a new solution, we can make use of this. So this is the introduction. Consider the rise in online shopping transactions due to the COVID-19 lockdown across various states of the Federation and the desire of citizens to receive these items at their doorstep without having to visit the supermarket, retail stores, or marketplaces, etc. It beholds on NIPOST, therefore, to carry out its core mandate of serving as delivery agent to citizens across the states. In view of this development, NIPOST should leverage on the solution that can facilitate a pickup and delivery service in order to bring the gap between the merchants and the customers. NIPOST logistics solution. We're talking about the solution that was demonstrated before you yesterday. So we'll take a critical look at this this page. If there's any modification you feel that we should make here, please just jot it down so that when it's time for discussion, you can actually add your input. To effectively manage this service, ICT department found the NIPOST logistics solution capable of handling these tasks, although not without slight modifications. NIPOST logistics solution is a platform developed by NIPOST in 2019 for handling pickup and delivery service for e-commerce merchants. Currently, the e-commerce and logistics CPU is using this solution to handle delivery of Jumia items in selected locations nationwide, and other companies, both local and cross-border e-commerce merchants, are in process of integrating with the solution. Capability: it can handle pickup for merchants. It has an interface and an API documentation that makes it easy for any store or merchant to integrate and request pickup. It has a backend that enables merchants to track their items. It has a module for updating item status and delivery information. It has a mobile version to facilitate timely pickup and quick delivery. It has a reporting module for auditing and decision making. It has a payment gateway integrated. Overview of the solution. The solution has a merchant interface front end and NIPOST interface back end. The merchant interface front end of the solution allows merchant to create orders. Creating order means captures information about item orders. This can be done either by single transactions or bulk upload. Request pickup by the post office attached to merchant's location. Get update on items movement process to delivery. Receive payment invoice. Raise dispute and process payment. For merchants with already existing online platform, the solution can be integrated with their platform through an API. While merchants without existing platform can leverage on the merchant's interface through the web. Overview of the solution continue. The NIPOST interface backend of the solution is managed by the designated post office, and it allows NIPOST to, one, receive notification of pickup request, either through the web or mobile version, manage pickup request by dispatching an officer to pick up, update item movement process to delivery, prepare invoices for merchant at the end of the day, month, or reconcile payment dispute reporting. Then reporting. This pickup interface can either be accessed using the web or through the mobile solution, which could be configured on any mobile service. The overview also continue update and delivery. These features allow item pickup from merchants to be updated with current delivery information. We have the following: scan in, receive at office of pickup, scan out, sent to next office, act for delivery, attempted delivery, delivered, sent back to sender. Now this is the process flow. Customers order items from a merchant. Is a merchant with online platform. If it is no, merchant capture order information on merchant interface via web. That's the NIPOST merchant interface. Then if the merchant has yes, merchant sends pickup request to NIPOST single or bulk. Then if also yes, the NIPOST gets notification of pickup. Pickup is done and taken to for delivery. Item are delivered, invoice is generated and sent to merchant for payment. Then when merchant doesn't have, merchant use the interface and also get to the merchant, sends pickup and also do the other thing. So uses the interface for NIPOST if it doesn't have his own interface. So this just creates order form. This the pickup order dashboard, as I look up pickup data, that's data that is picked up, invoice page, these are the invoice page look, payment reconciliation, the merchant is expected to make payment for items delivered at the office, delivered at the period, day, week, an invoice is generated and sent to merchant through the platform for payment. Various payment options has been integrated to the platform to enable merchant make payments seamlessly. Also, payment can be made at bank and detail entered on the platform for reconciliation. In the case of invoice dispute, a disputed procedure has been configured on the platform to handle such dispute and reconciliation. Okay. Additional information, pay on delivery. Considering the fact that some customers may want to make payment on delivery, POS terminal can be configured for payment at the point of delivery. Pickup time can be set daily to enable dispatch officers go around and pick up orders before proceeding for delivery. Identifier number. Solution has the ability to generate an identifier number for pickup items. Similar for merchant with existing platform, the order number can serve as identifier number. Assigning a post office, a merchant is assigned a post office closest to the pickup location of the merchant to facilitate speedy pickup and delivery. Conclusion, NIPOST logistics solution has the capability to handle various forms of pickup and delivery service, most especially in this critical time of COVID-19 lockdown. Both small merchants like grocery stores and big e-commerce merchants can be on board on this platform. There's flexibility of onboarding individual business to request pickup service. Some will leave there. Considering the features and capability of the solution, there's no doubt that it can handle all forms of pickup services. However, modification can be made where necessary. Should there be need to broaden the scope of the solution. Thank you.
Please, so, all right, thank you very much. Though you were a bit fast, I'm sure the people were able to grab what we are trying to do. Mr. Gabriel, are you still online, sir?
I think he has gone.
Okay, all right. Mr. Irabo, Mrs. Modi, and those other people who were not part of the deliberation the other time, because Mr. Irabo and Mrs. Modi were part of the subcommittee that came up with this idea. So for those of us that are seeing it for the first time, do we see that solution that was presented to us yesterday as a solution that can be used for pickup service during this lockdown? Can you still hear me, please?
Yes, we can hear you.
We can hear you.
Okay. We have just gone through the presentation, what we intend to sell or present to management tomorrow. I said, do we see the solution?